लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स और ताजा तरीन खबरों के लिए टीवी वन इंडिया लाइव को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और नोटिफिकेशन पाने के लिए बेल आइकॉन को दबाना मत भूलिए।
I suggest we start, Narendra. Namaste. Prime Minister Modi, dear Narendra, it's wonderful to see you, and I hope all is well with you and that you are in good health. And I'm so glad we have this chance to talk today online. And let me start by saying that I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for your kind message of congratulations on Twitter after the elections in the Netherlands. You were one of the first heads of government to congratulate me, and I really appreciate that. And I look forward to bolstering the close ties between the Netherlands and India in the years ahead. In a normal world, in a more perfect world, I'd have come to visit you in person. My previous visits to India in 2015 and 2018 made a big impression on me. Your country's energy, creativity, and your country's hospitality are truly without equal. Unfortunately, you and I, we all are still dealing with the COVID-19 pandemic, which makes travel impossible. But let me say how much I appreciate your government's efforts to support Dutch investors who faced challenges last year during the first wave of the pandemic. Your support helped ensure the continuation of trade between our countries, even in those difficult times. And we also appreciated the air bubble, which was an agreement between our two countries. And this enabled our national carrier, KLM, Royal Dutch Airlines, to bring many Dutch and EU citizens back to Europe, and to return Indian citizens to India, including many coming from Latin America. It shows that good cooperation makes all the difference, even in the most difficult of times. Fortunately, the ties between India and the Netherlands are strong, and they are growing stronger. In February, the Netherlands undertook a virtual trade mission to India, led by our trade minister, Sigrid Kaag, with a focus on the food, energy and water sectors. It was a long-distance mission conducted via screens, but it was still highly successful. The trade mission was the perfect follow-up to the state visit our king and queen paid to India in October 2019. There, they were joined by a delegation of no fewer than 140 companies and knowledge institutions. And the numbers speak for themselves. In 2019, our bilateral trade increased by 27%. The Netherlands is truly the gateway to the European continent for Indian companies. What's more, in 2020, the Netherlands rose to become the third biggest investor in India. And India is the fourth biggest investor in the Netherlands. These are fantastic milestones in our country's relationship. But our ties go far beyond economic matters alone. First, it's worth noting that the Netherlands has the largest Indian community on the European continent. And we host more than 2,000 Indian university students. We are proud of their achievement, and we are proud of their contributions to our society. And our countries are bonded in many other areas too. We both believe in democracy and the rule of law, in strong institutions and multilateral cooperation, and in open and fair world trade. At a time when these values are under increasing pressure, it's important to form and protect global coalitions. So I hope that we can also expand the relationship between India and the European Union as a whole. And with that in mind, it's worth looking ahead today to the EU-India summit that will take place in Portugal next month. Together with France and Germany, the Netherlands is pushing for an EU strategy on the Indo-Pacific. For the EU, India is a key partner in this region. We want to collaborate with countries that share our vision of a free and open Indo-Pacific region grounded in the international legal order. The Netherlands aims to take a leading role in those discussions. In 2018, I had the honor to give a speech in New Delhi at the beautiful Bikaner House, where I pledged to make a personal investment in the EU-India relationship. For the European Union, like the Netherlands, India is a crucial partner, both in the region and in the world at large. Take, for example, the United Nations. The Netherlands welcomes India's commitment to COVAX as an essential partner in terms of accessing vaccines for low and middle-income countries. And we applaud India for the vaccine Maitri program. We also congratulate India on its 8th election as a non-permanent member of the UN Security Council. You and I, we both support UN reform, which includes making the Security Council more representative. In our view, India is an obvious candidate for a permanent seat on an expanded council. In the G20 as well, India plays a crucial role. During recent G20 presidencies, the Netherlands has proven itself to be a constructive partner, and we will be honored to contribute during India's presidency too, with expertise in areas like infrastructure, financial inclusion, climate adaptation, and innovation in agriculture. In closing, I'd like to thank India and you, Prime Minister, dear colleague Narendra, for participating in the recent climate adaptation summit. And I look forward to working together on global challenges in the run-up to the UN Climate Summit, the COP26. In short, our countries have many shared values, have many shared priorities, and we have plenty to talk about today. I look forward to a highly productive exchange. Thank you.
Excellency, Namaskar. और आपके विचारों के लिए बहुत-बहुत धन्यवाद आपके नेतृत्व में आपकी पार्टी की लगातार चौथी बड़ी जीत हुई है इसके लिए मैंने ट्विटर पर तो तुरंत ही आपको बधाई दी थी लेकिन आज वर्चुअली मिलते हैं तो मैं आपको फिर से एक बार बहुत-बहुत बधाई देता हूं और शुभकामनाएं देता हूं एक्सेलेंसी हमारे संबंध डेमोक्रेसी और रूल ऑफ लॉ जैसे शेयर्ड वैल्यूज पर आधारित हैं क्लाइमेट चेंज टेररिज्म पैंडेमिक्स जैसी वैश्विक चुनौतियों पर हमारी अप्रोच एक समान है इंडो पैसिफिक रेजिलिएंट सप्लाई चेन्स और ग्लोबल डिजिटल गवर्नेंस जैसे नए क्षेत्रों में भी हमारे बीच कन्वर्जेंस बन रहा है आज हम अपनी स्ट्रेटेजिक पार्टनरशिप ऑन वाटर से इस सिलसिले को एक नया आयाम देंगे इन्वेस्टमेंट प्रमोशन के लिए फास्ट ट्रैक मैकेनिज्म की स्थापना भी हमारे मजबूत इकोनॉमिक कोऑपरेशन को नया मोमेंटम देगी मुझे विश्वास है कि पोस्ट कोविड काल में कई नए अवसर उत्पन्न होंगे जिनमें हमारे जैसे लाइक माइंडेड देश आपसी सहयोग बढ़ा सकते हैं एक्सेलेंसी 2019 में देयर मैजेस्टीज की भारत यात्रा से भारत नेदरलैंड संबंधों में नई ऊर्जा आई है मुझे विश्वास है कि आज हमारी वर्चुअल समिट के समिट से उन्हें और गति मिलेगी एक्सेलेंसी मैं भारतीय मूल के लोगों के विषय में आपने जो कहा ये बात सही है कि पूरे यूरोप में भारतीय मूल की बहुत बड़ी तादाद में लोग वहां रह रहे हैं, लेकिन इस कोरोना कालखंड में, इस पैंडेमिक में, आपने भारतीय मूल के लोगों को जिस प्रकार से उनकी चिंता की, उनको संभाला, उसके लिए मैं आपका हृदय से आभार व्यक्त करता हूं। और COP26 के समय भी, या हमारा जब यूरोपियन यूनियन के साथ भारत यू समिट होगा, उस समय भी हमें बहुत सारे विषयों पर चर्चा करने का अवसर मिलेगा।